What is two-factor authentication? In today's video, we're going to discuss exactly what it is and how we can make an effective use of this added layer of online security. Now, whether you're logging into your email, your social media, your bank, or some other online application, you're probably going to run into two-factor authentication. By definition, it is a second way to authenticate that you are who you say you are when you're trying to log in. It goes a little bit deeper than just your password. It is another more secure way to identify you. Now, right now, I'm going to walk through three different ways that this is done, two of which involve your mobile phone. Number one, two-factor authentication via text message. Now, in this method, my phone number becomes part of my account so that when I log in, they automatically send me a text message with a numeric code. Now, I will take this text message and input it into the second step of the login process, and I'm in. Now, for me, the text message usually arrives in 5 to 10 seconds, and with 6 to 8 digits, it adds an additional, let's say, 20 seconds to the login process. It's a bit clunky, but it works as an added layer of security. Number two, two-factor authentication via an app. Now, there are a number of ways that this is done, but the most popular is the Google Authenticator app, available on both the Android and iOS stores. Now, for this method, setup is really simple. You download the app and then you scan a QR code with your mobile device. When it comes time to log in, you'll be asked for a 6-digit number. This 6-digit number changes every 10 to 20 seconds based on an algorithm, and you don't have to be connected to the network or to Wi-Fi in order for that algorithm and that 6-digit code to work. Finally, number three, two-factor authentication via a security key, such as this Titan security key by Google. Now, this is a method that's been used by tech companies for a while, but it's just now being made available to us consumers. And it is by far my favorite method of two-factor authentication because it is so simple. Once you've set it up, plug this USB key into your computer or keep this Bluetooth-enabled fob, which I keep on my keychain, next to your phone, and there's no need to input any extra codes. Now, obviously, the upside to this is that it's really fast, it's really easy. The downside, these keys do cost a little bit of money. Now, if this is a method you like, and I recommend it, I've created a video to walk you through the purchase and setup process for these keys. Okay, now that you know the methods, I'm going to walk you through just an example of how to set up two-factor authentication. Okay, let's take a look at how this is going to work in an application like Facebook. As you see here, I am on the security two-factor authentication page. In the future, the way that you get to this might change, but the essence is you want to go to settings, you're looking for security and login, and then you want to find two-factor authentication. And in this case, I'm going to go ahead and get started. I'm going to show you all three ways that we can get this done. First is via text message. And in that case, they're going to send you a 6-digit code because I've got this phone number for my phone already part of my account. And when I get that number, I input it here. Or, and this is the other way I'm going to do it, I could set it up with an Authenticator app like Google Authenticator. So I'm going to go ahead and open my Google Authenticator app. I'm going to click to scan a barcode. And as you see, I scan that barcode, it adds another number to my Authenticator app, and I'm going to type in that number right here, which is going to change quickly if I don't type it in fast. So I've got Google Authenticator on. Now, that's how I did the Authenticator app. If I wanted to do the security key, I can click setup, and as you see here, I have my security key. I'm going to plug it into my computer and then press the button, and that's going to add my security key to my Facebook account. And then I'm done. If I refresh this page, you'll see that I've got both a security key, an Authenticator app, and if I wanted to, I could set up text message and recovery codes, which are another less secure way of doing two-factor authentication. Now, whether you use the text message, the app, or the security key method, the bottom line is that you need to enable two-factor authentication today. It only takes 5 to 10 minutes to set it up. I recommend for your bank, for your email, and even for your social media sites if that's something that you use. I've added a link for these security keys in the description below this video, as well as a VPN recommendation. I use ExpressVPN that secures me whenever I'm out and about using a public network, like let's say the airport Wi-Fi or a coffee shop Wi-Fi. That's just, again, an added layer of security to make sure that I'm not vulnerable when I'm going online and logging into all these accounts. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. Like this video if it was helpful, and then I've got tons of other helpful videos about online security and VPNs on this channel. Thanks so much for watching.